What's happening, folks, and welcome to an episode of Stars of Tomorrow, another FM Wonder Kids series. We look at some of the young players on FM 20, both at players that you guys pick and players that I decide to look at as well, and we see how they get on over the course of their careers. Look at all aspects of their contracts, their injuries, their stats, obviously the big thing, and also the stats of their goals and assists and all that kind of stuff as well, and also the fees they get paid to sign for the clubs for. So thank you for watching today. If you've got a player you want to look at, down below, leave a comment about the player. We have got a bit of a backlog right now, but I'm trying to get episodes about daily as well, so you guys get a lot of this content, and we get through the list a bit quicker. Down below, guys, usual thing, Discord link down below to my Discord. If you want to get involved in that, just show me your saves or ask or talk to me away from the videos. I'm always willing to talk to subscribers / viewers, so if you want to do that, that's completely fine. Love to see you in there. And check out the second channel with the non-FM stuff on there if you want to do that as well. And if that's not enough, Twitch is back. We are streaming 4 times a week. 3 of those days are FM, maybe 2, depending how best I feel things are going. In terms of, you know, how much time I'm playing the game. If I want to do something a bit more non-FM here for a couple of days. So today's player is a viewer suggested player. It is Sandro Tonali. I'm pretty sure you all know about him. He's one of the things. Last year was one of the guys everyone bought. This year, I think he could be another one of them. So we're going to look how he gets on, guys. I'm interested to see it as well because I'm considering signing him, or I've signed him on my Man United Twitch save. So that is going to be just to see how he gets on. So first jump, guys, let's go. Right, folks, he's now 23 years old. He's moved to Dortmund, and I hate looking at you there on this game. It really makes me have a headache. And you can see we've had increases across the board on, I think, most things, at least by one. Ones that stand out, obviously, are the ones I've put in the little orange colour, because it's like, just stands out easier, I think. 16 for his first touch, 17 passing, 17 technique, good vision and work rate, good positioning, high determination, composure really high as well, and the physicals are very, very good as well. For a centre midfielder, that's fantastic. I would love that in my team, and I've got it in my team, actually, essentially. So, player traits. He tries to clear balls often, dictates tempo, does not dive in tackles, tries long-range passes. So, definitely a deep line playmaker. He's equally okay in both positions, which is fantastic. So, if you play a DM or two centre midfielders only, you've covered with that, which is fantastic. So, he's reasonable left foot and very strong his right foot. So, left foot, not too much of an issue. History, injury-wise, pretty damn good. Not too bad at all, really. I'm happy with that. So, let's have a look how he got on here. So, first year, he didn't get many assists. We got a lot of games. We got 1 goal, 8 assists. Then got, obviously, moved to Dortmund for £26 million. Didn't play much that year. This year, played 33 total and got 4 goals and 9 assists. So, obviously, with the fact he's playing centre midfield, he's not going to get a massive amount of assists. He's not got a long shot technique, long shot trait on him. You could try and work it in, I suppose, if you really wanted to, but I don't think you really need to, really. I think he's the kind of guy that slots in midfield, does the busy work in midfield, and gets it to you like your wingers and your attacking midfielders. Or if you're getting counter-attacks and which like making running behind, long-range passes because of that long-range passing trait. If you've got a speedy striker, let's say you've signed Erling Haaland from the early review, then these two could be a pretty good combination if you can get counter-attacks. And also, ain't bad on corners. 15 corners, well, ain't bad on corners either. So, you know, added bonus there. So, yeah, 23 years old, worth £56 million. Let's go forward now, guys. Another jump. So, folks, he's moved to Man City and he's worth £86 million. And look at the stats. I don't need to go through them all to just show you how good this guy is, and the mental stats are insane, and physically he's fantastic. Same player traits are there. I think we've got 2 more. We've got avoid weaker foot, and I think the come deep to get the ball is a new one. So £86 million, how injury prone he's not. So we'll look. So Dortmund first year, that year you got 4 goals, 9 assists, then 19 assists, then 19 games. 1 goal, 0 assist. Went to Man City for £97 million. And first year got 3 goals, 3 assists. Then he got 5 and 8. 15 goals and 9 assists. 12 goals, 10 assists. And 14 goals, 6 assists. So where are they playing him then? centre mid. Long shots not great, but yeah. Did not see a lot of goals coming from this guy. I thought we might get a high assist record because of the longest passes and vision and the technique and passing, obviously very high. But yeah, he's getting goals for fun. Again, it is Man City, so they're getting a lot of the ball. But yeah, brilliant stuff. And I would definitely say get him early on because the fee rockets. So get him early on, guys, if you're going to sign him. So yeah, one more jump, guys, into his 30s and see how he gets on at Man City. Or if he goes somewhere else, how he gets on there. Right, folks, he's still at Man City, and physicality-wise, he's still up there. He's going really well. I think everything's basically stayed the same. Maybe slight increases here in the mental attributes. But at 32, he's still a god of midfield, and we've still got the same traits on him, which is... Oh, I've got one more. Runs the ball often. Okay, Jimmy's 14. Doable. Doable, I suppose. So, injuries. One major injury. Well, two, really, but... too much injury at the end of his career, so not too bad. He was in training as well, so just unfortunate. So how did he do at City? So we got 15 goals, 9 assists there. Then 12 and 10, 14 and 6, 9 and 12, 3 and 7, 15 and 11, and then 10 and 9. So you're getting a guy who not only has got insane technical abilities in terms of passing and creativity, he's got great free kicks, obviously 16 we saw, so that's where probably he's getting a lot of free goals from, I assume. A few of you, you'd think, anyway. All around physically, he looks great. There's nothing there that really worries me at all. Maybe the jumping reach, if being ultra picky, but I don't think it's an issue. And the mental stats are just, well, they're mental, for the want of a better word. So, yeah, really good player, guys. I would say get him early on because obviously he will cost a lot of money. If you can get him early on for like the money they pay for him, you've got a midfielder who I generally think could be in your midfield for a very, very long time. Even into his 34 years old, I think he could play in there. You might need more legs around him. You might need more legs around him around that time, but get him early on. I think he's set for a good few years for midfielders, or at least one midfielder anyway in your team. Tomorrow's episode, guys, is going to be a Barcelona player who I forget how you say his name. I don't want to mess his name up and end up looking like an idiot, at least more than I do already. So yeah, I'll see you tomorrow, guys, for another upload. Until then, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye. Oh, I found